Hey guys, welcome to another episode of Whisk Affair. I am Nehamathur and today I have a very simple recipe to make curd rice for you all. Now you might be thinking that why curd rice? Just rice and curd, but no, it's much more than that. And there are little tricks which take this dish from a very basic simple curd rice meal to a, you know, nice family comfort kind of a meal. So come, let's waste no time and see how to make this delicious curd rice at home.
I'll start by adding rice in a pan. I have taken a short grain rice here. I have taken sona masuri, but you can take any variety of rice, but make sure it's a short grain rice. And you know, when cooked, it's slightly mushy. I'll add 1.5 cup of water here. Now, generally when we make rice, we usually take double the amount of water, but here we want to make our rice a little mushy. So I have taken a little more than the double the amount. So we'll let this rice cook until it absorbs all the water. Now let the rice cool down before we add other ingredients to it.
The rice is completely cooled and now we'll add curd to it. I'm using homemade curd, but you can go ahead and use store-bought curd as well. And it's better if the curd is very, very slightly sour because it will give a very nice taste to the curd rice. And now because the rice is freshly made, it will also absorb the curd and the milk that we are going to add to it. And it will be like very, very flavorful. Although you can make curd rice with the leftover rice, but this is the only constraint it comes when you're using leftover rice, because the, you know, the rice which is cooked prior, it will not absorb all these things so well as fresh made rice. I'm also adding some milk to it. Grated carrot. And salt. Now mix all this very well and we'll chill this rice for at least an hour. Curd rice tastes best when it is chilled, so what I do is I make the curd rice until this stage and then I refrigerate it until we are ready to eat it, and when once we are ready to eat, I make a fresh tempering and pour it over the curd rice and then I serve it immediately. So that way you get the chilled rice with a fresh tempering on top. It's mixed well. Try to mash it a little bit with the back of your spoon. You can even use your hands to do it, but I, when the rice is cooked very properly, even a spoon can work well. I'll refrigerate it for some time now. Now let's make the tempering for the curd rice. I'll start by adding some oil in a pan. Once the oil is hot, I'll add some mustard seed and curry leaves to it and let them crackle for a few seconds. Now add Urad Dal, grated ginger and a dry red chilli. Now ginger is optional here. If you do not like ginger in your dishes, you can skip it. I personally love ginger in all my recipes and I make sure to add it. You can also add some green chili at this stage. Again, you can skip the green chili if you're making curd rice for kids and people who do not like, you know, like really hot food. Now we'll fry it until the dal turns slightly brown, which you can see here. And now we'll pour the tempering over a chilled curd rice. Curd rice is perfectly chilled. And now we'll pour this tempering over it. You can either mix this tempering in the entire rice or just keep it like this. I prefer to keep it like this because it looks visibly very beautiful. And now the last part is garnishing it. So sprinkle a lot of chopped coriander over it and some pomegranate seeds. So these seeds not only gives a beautiful color to this rice, but they also add to a nice crunch. You can serve this rice as it is, or the perfect accompaniments for this are some fried aplams, which is rice papad, a side of pickle, and that's it. So it makes a great meal on its own. Enjoy this curd rice. This curd rice recipe is my comfort food, and I'm sure that after trying this recipe, you will fall in love with it. So do not forget to try it out, share it with your family and friends, and enjoy this really nice and refreshing dish. If you like this recipe, do not forget to like, share and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Do not forget to press on the bell icon to get all the notifications whenever I post a new recipe. If you have any questions or any query, leave me a comment below and I'll definitely try to revert back. I'll see you all very soon with a new recipe. Till then, bye-bye.